In this video, we will be reviewing Unit 1, which includes an introduction to the CS Academy graphics package through creating drawings. The first program you learned is how to draw a rectangle, and this involves rect, open parentheses, leftmost point, top point, width, and height. So when we put in numbers there, we pretty much choose, as you can see in this example, the x value, the y value, and then the width and the height. You can also put comments in your code, but this will never be read by Python. Instead, this is just to help you code and clear up any confusion you or anyone grading your code might have to deal with. In addition, it's important to keep in mind some features we discussed, such as the auto grader, which allows for a grading of all of your exercises, and the errors in the program, which you keep an eye out for, such as errors where the Python isn't properly being run, or if the auto grader does not think your code is correct. So going back to this example, we have this rectangle drawn. When we run it, here is our output rectangle with a color black. It's also important to note that the top leftmost point is 0, 0, and then X increases as you move along the horizontal, Y increases as you move down the vertical, which is a little different than we're normally used to when we're graphing, such that the largest point, 400, 400, is in the bottom right. Once we can draw a rectangle, we can actually start adding colors and other interesting features to our drawings. So first is color, or fill. So whenever we want to add color, after we put all the basic points in for our shape, we can have fill equals, and then one of three options. Either we could have a color in quotes, RGB values, or none, which pretty much just means that the fill is see-through, it's transparent. So RGB values are always written like this, RGB parentheses, and then three numbers separated by commas, where the numbers are all between 0 and 255. Next, we have borders, where we can do both border and border width. Border takes a color in quotes, while border width takes a value. So border chooses the color of the border, border width chooses the thickness of the border. And finally, we have dashes, which can take either true or can input a dash width and a gap width. So let's take a look at this in action. We have a rectangle up here with a fill of medium sea green. So this is just a color in quotes. This is built into the CS Academy graphics package. Then we have a rectangle with a RGB value. So again, we have fill equals with our RGB setup. And here is that rectangle over here. It looks kind of like purple. And then we have three different squares on the bottom. Here they are with fill plum, all with the border navy, but different border attributes. So the first one has a border width of 4, so you can see that that's pretty large. Then we have dashes just equal to true, so this is the generic dashes setup. And finally, we inputted our own dash width and gap width, and here it is with some extra long dashes and pretty small width as we specified. With our fill, we can also create gradients, which is just fading from one color to another. This can be done by using it as an argument for fill or border, which I'll show below in our example. And just to note, there are two kinds of gradients we can use, which are radial, which starts from the center and fades outwards, and linear, which need a starting spot for the gradient. And it can be used by specifying words like left, right, left top, right bottom, etc. So let's take a look at this example. So we have our first rectangle all the way to the left on the canvas, and we do fill equals gradient, open parentheses, then the colors in order that you want to see fade with a starting point at the right. So all the way to the right, we have salmon going into tomato, going into orange, red. Now, here's another linear gradient. We have fill equals gradient, hot pink to blue. We start at the left top, and here you can see the hot pink going all the way to the blue. And finally, we have a radial gradient at number 3, and we have a fill gradient with red, orange, yellow, blue, no start specified because radial is the default. And here it is, red to yellow to blue. Another parameter we can modify for shapes is opacity. Opacity is the lack of transparency of an object, and it ranges from 0 to 100. where 0 opacity means completely transparent and 100 is not at all transparent. It's also important to know that when you're drawing, when you're coding and you're trying to draw something, the drawing order is the same as the code order, which I'll demonstrate in the example. So let's take a look at these three rectangles, the first of which is our gold rectangle, where you see it here all the way in the back, which is because it was drawn first. Then we have a second rectangle, which is blue. Again, both of these have no modified opacity. And finally, we have this rectangle over here in line 3 with an opacity of 50, so it's halfway transparent. And you can see part of the gold rectangle behind it. Aside from rectangles, there are a lot of other shapes that the CS Academy graphics package can handle, and here are a list of some of them. There's oval, which takes in a center X, a center Y, and a width and a height. We have a circle, which takes in center X, center Y, and a radius. We have line that takes in two points, X1, Y1, and X2, Y2, and connects the two of them. We have a regular polygon, which needs a center X, center Y, a radius, and points. So this behaves similarly to drawing hexagons, pentagons. You choose a center, how wide it's going to be, and the number of points that that shape has. A star is very similar. It has a center X, center Y, radius, and points, but it can also take in a roundness. So these light blue parameters are actually optional. Then we have polygon, in which you just list off the points you want connected, X1, Y1, X2, Y2, X3, Y3, and it goes about connecting them. And finally, we have label, which actually allows you to put text onto the canvas. So value is whatever the text you want. It could be hi, hello, click here, welcome to the game, whatever. Then you have center X, center Y, and the size. And here are some optional parameters, which include font, fill, border, bold, and italic, with bold and italic being true or false. Here we have a bunch of examples of all the previously discussed shapes and labels. So let's go through them real quick. At the top, we have an oval and a circle. So here on line 1, here is our oval with a center of 80-40, a width of 60, and a height of 30. See that it is longer than it is tall, with a fill of medium slate blue. Then we have a circle with a border of black right next to it, and a label saying this is the difference between an oval and a circle. Then we have a line drawn with a fill of red right here. Another label that says now polygons. And here are some of our polygons. We have a regular polygon where we have set its center to 70-170, given it a radius of 40 and points of 3. So we made a triangle. And here's a polygon where we just gave it 4 points and it connected it. So here they are listed out with a fill. And finally, here are some examples of stars. These two stars have the same number of points, but this one is much rounder, with a roundness of 80 instead of 30, and it almost looks like a pentagon, so you can play around with what function calls, which type of shape you use to draw regular everyday shapes, because you can draw a pentagon using regular polygon or a star. And finally, we have a very, very pointy star, which has 8 sides and a very, very small roundness. An important feature that is part of the CS Academy curriculum is the inspector. You should always, 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 always use the inspector when you are doing exercises. It's super important for identifying important points as well as properties to create the shapes that you need to solve the exercises. The inspector provides information necessary to solve them. As you can see over here, whenever you scroll over a canvas, this is a screenshot so you can't quite see it, but whenever you hover over the canvas, like so, you will see all of these points pop up that are major points to help you draw the shapes necessary to complete the exercise. You will also see the colors, the point values, and based on this, you can go about completing the exercises. Thanks for tuning in. I hope that this helped you in your review of Unit 1. Make sure to check out all of our review materials online and the notes at the CS Academy website.